6 magnitude occurred on the Cascadia fault line. As a result of this earthquake, a large tsunami was generated, and it is expected to impact the west coast within 30 minutes. Wave heights cannot be predicted at this time. All residents on the beach and in low-lying areas are advised to evacuate immediately. Follow designated evacuation routes, which will lead you to higher ground. Please proceed in a quick, but orderly fashion. If you have children at school, do not attempt to pick them up as they are being evacuated to higher grounds now. Do not use your telephone at this time. Leave the lines open for emergency use.
I remember getting the call vividly. I was trying to finish up for the day, but a stack of paperwork was keeping me late. To be honest, I was also looking for reasons not to go home. My phone rang, answered it, and the director of the Institute was talking, albeit disjointedly, about something that had turned up in a recent survey of the Sirena Deep.
Control, this is Sierra Echo 1. Connected to docking walkway. Now leaving the battlesphere.
Copy that.
She described something that showed up in sonar imagery, 200 to 300 meters long, and too regular in shape to be a natural formation. I thought she was getting ahead of herself when she called it a facility, but more detailed scans seemed to confirm this.
I'm in a central hall. Seems to be where the living quarters were. There's a number of cells along the wall. No other trace of life here. Seems to have been abandoned. It's odd. The construction looks like it's from the 1980s or 90s.
Copy.
Control.
Sierra Echo 1, this is Control. We're seeing considerable elevation in your heart rate. Is everything okay?
Yes, I'm fine. Could you monitor my external readings for anything out of the ordinary?
Roger.
Thing is, there's no record of any structure of this size having been constructed underwater anywhere. And certainly none at a depth of 10 kilometers below sea level. So who built this thing? When? And why? I've so many questions.
Coming Control, are you picking up anything unusual in my external readings?
Negative, Sierra Echo 1. We are registering continued elevation in your heart rate and blood pressure, however, which indicates acute emotional distress. We advise caution.
I'm fine. Over and out.
I was chosen to pilot a bathysphere down to the structure and investigate it. An atmospheric diving suit was obviously necessary at that depth, but I've been working on a new suit that utilised highly sophisticated equipment for underwater surveys. This seemed like the perfect opportunity to test it out.
What looks like a storage room. Can't tell what was stored here. I'm still not sure what the purpose of this facility was.
Sierra Echo 1, we recommend returning to the bathysphere. Your vitals are highly erratic and we're concerned for your well-being.
I can't yet. Everything's fine. Over and out.
Yes, I'm aware of the dangers of a dive to that depth. Of course I am. I've been diving for most of my life. And this didn't seem like something I could pass up. The mystery consumed me. I have to know what it is.
Echo 1, this is Control. We order you to immediately withdraw from the facility. Your behaviour is jeopardising your safety.
I have to find out.
Please, Echo.
Everything was black. And then I opened my eyes.